George W. Bush returns to America after spending 4 years in the Himalayas. Neil Armstrong's wife is happy she can finally get rid of all his space hobby crap. And the Romney campaign reboots for the 72nd straight week. Your hordes of emails, handwritten letters, and homemade video recordings pitifully pleaded for more. So here it is, The Onion Week in Review. Responding to the widespread criticism of voting procedures that have plagued the state since the 2000 election, Florida officials have announced their plan to experiment with new 600-lever voting machines. The 22-foot-tall machines, which Florida officials are hailing as, quote, the future of voting, each feature over 45 separate panels of levers, including 270 just to ensure chads are fully punched.
First, the voter walks into the booth, then turns on the machine using these 30 levers at the top. Right about now, the voter's gonna have to find the two levers on the machine that are exactly identical. Screw in one of the three fuses, rather like a Rubik's Cube. It's right about this time where we're gonna ask people to bring in their own pipe wrench from home. They will get a tiny shock. Now, if they are wrong, and then they'll pull the final lever, and the ballot will be cast. Some of this may seem confusing, but every voter will be given a comprehensive 2,200-page manual when they enter their precinct that will explain exactly what to do.
Following a recent statement from the American Academy of Pediatrics touting the benefits of circumcision, the nation's creepy middle school gym teachers have also come out in favor of the medical procedure, saying that they, quote, just want to see happy, healthy boys out there without unsightly folds of skin covering their glands. Creepy gym teachers everywhere declared circumcised penises more hygienic and aesthetically pleasing.
Well, it's not like we dislike uncircumcised penises per se. We just simply find them less than ideal for our young, strapping students. While we're at it, we'd like to take a moment to denounce childhood obesity and its disastrous effects on the firmness of pubescent breasts.
In what many are calling the worst scandal in the history of the church, Scientology minister Frank Linehan was arrested this week on 471 charges of molesting thetans. The 56-year-old minister was taken into custody after an investigation revealed he abused dozens of the ancient alien spirits in the past year alone.
This is not what we stand for, and I'd like to apologize to all of the thetans and their host bodies affected by this horrible tragedy. In these difficult times, I've urged my parishioners to continue their solo auditing sessions to free the reactive mind from engrams and gain full control of matter, energy, and space-time, like everything's normal.
And in election news, sources within the Obama campaign confirmed today the president is unsure how he could possibly turn his huge support among women, Latinos, gays, and African Americans into an electoral victory. While Obama reportedly acknowledged that his comfortable leads among members of virtually every minority group in the country was, quote, nice, he's working closely with aides to figure out how such tremendous statistical advantages could somehow work in his favor on election day. In other news, a newly unemployed woman enjoys equal pay for the first time in her career. A teacher is hoping his students can tell he was once popular, and a friend who just got a motorcycle is already dead. Still not enough for you, huh? Well, you'll have to wait till next week, you sniveling video-addicted toadstool. Or for more, visit the onion.com/newsbeat.